previous example of free sculpting an entire head for a character, I've demonstrated sculpting the entire head as well as eyes and eyelids on a single mesh. As an additional method, it can be beneficial for us to instead bring in a separate mesh for the eyes by adding our first additional object or subtool. Before we bring in a new subtool, let's first carve out the eye sockets to give us a general idea for where to place the eyes. So I'm going to scale in very close here and focus on this target area. First, switching to the clay buildup brush, I can quickly start to carve out the eye socket shape. By carving out a teardrop shape here, this will get me started with what will be the eyelid. Now using the damn standard brush to carve underneath the top and bottom eyelid, and then smoothing out the surface. Continuing to sculpt in this area, I'm quickly using the move brush to shape the eyelid around the corners to get a nice clear vision of the entire shape for the eye. If you aren't sure about the shapes you're trying to create, find other references for different styles and shapes of eyes, and use the see-through option to quickly go back and forth with the transparency slider. Now that we have a place to put the eyes of the character, let's bring in a new object for the eyeballs. To add in a new object or subtool, we need to navigate to the subtool palette here inside of the tool palette. Inside of the subtool palette, you can see the current mesh that we're working on. Now, to keep things in order, I can rename my subtool by clicking Rename, typing in a name, and pressing Enter. To add a subtool to our scene, let's append in a new object by pressing the Append button here. Inside of the Append menu, we have a selection of 3D primitives to choose from. Now, the obvious choice here is a 3D sphere, so let's click on the Sphere 3D object to append it into our scene. Now the sphere has been added to our subtool palette, which we can rename, and you can also see it's been added into our scene. To more clearly see the sphere, by selecting it in the subtool palette, we can turn on the transparency mode here on the right. Now we need to just do a little bit of moving and scaling to get this eyeball in place. If we were to switch to the move brush and try to move this mesh, you can see that we're having just a bit of trouble here. To properly move and scale the eyeball, we're going to use what is called transpose. Transpose is a ZBrush feature that allows you to quickly position, pose, or deform your model. We can find the transpose options here at the top. With transpose, we have the option to move, scale, and rotate the selected object. First, we need to move the eyeball into place, so let's select the move transpose option. When selecting these options, we have a new tool that pops up on the canvas, which is called our transpose action line. By clicking and dragging from the mesh, I can draw a transpose action line in any direction. By also pressing the shift key, I can snap the action line to different angles. Each of these circle options on the transpose action line have a different purpose, or will manipulate the mesh in different ways. To move the mesh without distortion, we need to use the center circle. We can easily reposition the transpose action line to the perfect center of our mesh by pressing the white circle on the action line here. Now, simply click inside of the center circle to move the eyeball from our front orthographic view. Now, let's go in and rotate around the canvas while pressing Shift to lock to the side orthographic view. Now again, let's recenter the action line to the eyeball by pressing the white circle here, and again, click inside of the center circle to move this around the eye socket of her head. Now we've almost finished getting this in place. All that's left is scaling the eyeball to fit inside of the eye socket. To scale the eyeball, let's switch to our scale transpose option. This action line will always look the same, but now our three primary action line circle options will now apply different scale options to the mesh. In the case of transpose with scale, if we click and drag from the center circle, this will actually deform the mesh, which is not what we want. We want to keep this as a perfect spherical shape for the eyeball for now, so I'll press Ctrl Z to undo, and instead, let's click inside of the top or bottom options, which will scale the mesh without changing the shape or deforming the mesh. Now, if we click inside of the top circle, By dragging away from the center of the action line, this will scale the eyeball larger. If we drag towards the center, this will scale the eyeball smaller. If we click inside of the bottom circle by dragging away from the center of the action line, this will also scale the eyeball larger and smaller by dragging towards the center. Using either of these options, I can quickly scale the eyeball to the desired size to fit within the eye socket. The transpose tools have many controls and options that speed up the entire sculpting process in ZBrush. Now, we're focusing on just the basics at this point, so be sure to explore ZClassroom and the Ask ZBrush section on our YouTube channel to find out more about using all of the transpose options. When we're done moving and scaling the eye with transpose, in order to continue sculpting, we need to turn on draw mode. To turn draw mode on for sculpting, press the draw button here. Now that the eyeball is in place as a separate subtool, let's switch back to the Shark Boy subtool to continue working by clicking on it in the subtool palette. I'll disable the transparency option now and quickly just use the move brush to form the eye socket around the eyeball. By having separate subtools for different sculptural objects, this is a much more efficient way to adjust the shapes without deforming these areas when trying to move and shape the eyelid. When we've got the shapes all adjusted here, there is one last thing we need to do, which is mirroring the eyeball to the other side. So you can see on the left side, we still have an empty eye socket. To efficiently create a symmetrical eyeball on both sides of our scene, let's use a new feature called Mirror and Weld. First, let's click on the eyeball to select it in the subtool palette. Because this is dealing with modifying the geometry of the eyeball, let's go ahead and close the subtool palette and open up the geometry palette. Here at the bottom, we have the Modified Topology subpalette. Let's click once to open this up, and here we have the Mirror and Weld button. By default, our scene's symmetry line is mirroring in the x-axis. In this case, we want to mirror and weld the eyeball across the x-axis, which is already selected for the mirror and weld option here. Click the button to create an eyeball for the other side of the mesh. For more information on using this feature, be sure to visit ZClassroom and also ask ZBrush on our YouTube channel for more in-depth information. That should do it for adding the eyes for our character. In the next part of this series, we'll be focusing on quickly finalizing all of the shapes for the body. Thanks for visiting ZClassroom, and I'll see you in the next video.